Hey everyone, after a few months, we're back. I hope there's still someone here.
Where's everyone going? Bingo?
In the meantime, we've been working on a ton of stuff. Welcome to our fifth Devlog. Let's start with the visual updates. Now, our cards are unique in both their rarities and their sectors. It was a bit challenging to achieve the results we're about to show you. We went through several tests that were either discarded or reworked until we reached the final outcome. Plus, we had to render these 3D models multiple times, which required time from us and our computers. Let's take a look at how things turned out. All cards have levels represented by these stars. Level 1 and 2 cards are the most basic, featuring just the companies and nothing else. On level 3 cards, we have a backdrop along with the company. I'll explain the concept behind it in a bit, but notice that it's almost colorless, kind of dull, but still something. A card that's between the rarest and the most common. With level 4 cards, we see this backdrop in color, but it's still not the highest rarity level, so we have something even more elaborate. And that brings us to level 5, a card with an animated backdrop. It's the highest card level we have. Now, about the backdrops, we aim to create a backdrop that would represent the card sectors as much as possible. Even if the sector had companies that might not necessarily go together, the focus was on finding a middle ground that would encompass as many of them as possible. Did you like it? Let us know in the comments. We always need your feedback. How about we look at something more technical now? Story time! One day while surfing in the Maldives, Ven's CEO thought it would be really interesting for us to create our own engine that would help us both in building Capital Clash and in creating a future game. So that's what he did. Amid code, coffee, and Slay the Spire, he created NPC, Node Programming Card Engine. Still in development, one of the main features of this engine is the creation of cards. With it, we'll be able to create cards without using third-party programs and import these cards much more easily into our games. As mentioned in its name, this engine's main focus is the use of nodes, both for being a facilitator and for being a market trend. With this choice, we're not only developing a game, but also developing technology that will certainly be very useful. Now, have you ever thought about how the multiplayer match system of a game works? I'll give you three options to try to guess how things work. A. By magic. We stole a book from Aleister Crowley himself to do this. B. My uncle is Bill Gates. He did this for us. C. Programming. If you chose C, you're correct, unfortunately. The other options were cooler. Well, let's see how it works. Capital Clash's multiplayer system is based on a technology that connects you and your opponent simultaneously, where you receive immediate live updates regarding your opponent's actions, and vice versa. This technology is called WebSockets, and the implementation we use is called Socket.io. Let's see how it works. Imagine a social network where, instead of posting photos or status updates, you're playing an online game with your friends. In the world of online gaming, Socket.io is like that social network, connecting you to a gaming channel. When you join an online game that uses Socket.io, it's like subscribing to a page or group on a social network. By subscribing, you start receiving real-time updates about what's happening in the game, just like you would receive notifications when someone posts something in a group you're part of. In Socket.io, these updates are called events. Events can be anything from a player moving their character to someone scoring points or chatting in the game. Each time an event happens, it's like someone posting on your social network. If you're subscribed to that channel, you receive that update instantly. One of Socket.io's strengths is the ability to instantly communicate with all players in the channel. Just like on a social network where you can comment on a post and all other members can see your comment, in Socket.io, when a player takes an action, all other connected players receive that information immediately. This allows the game to flow smoothly and interactively, keeping all players in sync. To ensure that everyone stays updated without delays, Socket.io is designed to be very fast and efficient, maintaining a continuous connection between the game server and the players. It's as if the social network was optimized to ensure you never miss an update from your friends, no matter how many posts are shared. Using Socket.io in online games is like being in an extremely fast and interactive social network where every action you or your friends take is instantly shared, ensuring that everyone is always connected and engaged in the game world. And that's it! That's all for today. We hope to be back sooner with more updates. Subscribe and like. Follow us on our social networks, and stay tuned.